Hello viewers, how are you? During this meeting, I'm going to discuss with you about some basic forms of the organizational structures. So let me share a slide with you. Okay. Some common forms of the organizational structures include the simple structure, bureaucratic structure, and the matrix structure. So By a simple structure is that depicts a one person in the organization and who has a two or three employees or the four or five employees in the organization. That structure is more suitable with the smaller companies, which has a small setups. And since the 80% of the companies are the smaller companies, so their simple structure is suitable to those smaller companies. One example would be a shopkeeper who has a, let's say, three or four employees who are working with them. Another example would be a small restaurant where the five or six people are working with that person. Even 10 or 15 or 20 people who are working there, but it's a more, it does not require a lot of, it does not require a formalization. It does not require a specialization. People are doing the multi-task and they involve into the multiple kinds of work. So it's a simpler structure, and one I can show you that simple structure. You see, this is a one example of a simple structure. Okay, and then we have another form of the organizational structure, which we call the bureaucratic structure, and actually. Sometimes the people have a negative connotation of the bureaucracy, that the bureaucracy are sometimes related with the rigidity, lack of flexibility. But when the size of the organization grow, then you need to have some structure which basically coordinate the activities of the different people working in the organization. So original idea coined by the Max Weber, and that idea was to develop specialization, develop a clear chain of command in the organization. So bureaucracies are designed for efficiency, and they rely on high levels of work specialization, formalization, centralization of authority, a rigid and well-defined chain of command, that who is reporting to whom, and relatively narrow span of control. So you can see that the bureaucracies are more like a mechanistic organizations. There are different types of the bureaucracies. So one is basically a functional structure where you can basically group the people according to the functions they perform for the organization. And the most mechanistic of the bureaucratic organization, for example, the people who are working, who are doing the work of the marketing, they group under the marketing function. Similarly with the finance, manufacturing, human resource, and the information technology. So that develop the expertise of a person who is working in that department, but the trade-off is that the person has a lack of understanding about the working of the other department. And sometimes marketing has a less understanding about how the people working in the manufacturing, and the manufacturing has a less appreciation of the work with the marketing people are doing in the organization. Okay, that's a multi-divisional structure. Why we are calling it the multi-divisional? Because there are different kind of the divisions in the organization in which the employees are grouped together. One way of divisioning is to have a criteria of a function. On the basis of the function, you are creating a division in the organization. That's why it's called the multi-divisional organization. Okay, the second bureaucratic structure, the multi-divisional structure, is product structure, that employees are grouped according to their products that help the company to this kind of the structure actually help the employees to have an expertise of those particular products. And for example, the marketing and the sales company become specialized in those kinds of the toys. But the trade-off is that they have a less understanding about the other products of the company. But the benefit is that they focus on a one type of a product in the company. So that's basically product structure. Then we have another structure is the geographical structure. Employees are grouped according to their location. And there are many companies, let's say IBM is one example, Sony is another example, Nestle is another example, which are basically using a geographical structure in their companies. And the benefit of the geographical structure is that company come to know about the local needs and demands of the product, so they can better cater their needs and demands with the with their product and the services. So that is basically advantage of the geographical structure. For example, people living in a Pakistan have a different kind of a taste regarding their, let's say, McDonald's or KFC. They have a different kind of a preference of product presentations and the product advertisements in comparison to the some European companies. So that's a one way of organizing a company according to the location. Then you can also organize the company according to the basis of the kind of the client employees are grouped according to the type of the client which they are catering, the specific type of the client. For example, if they're government, the client, or a large company, they're a client, or a small company, they're a client. So you're grouping the employees according to the type of the client. So that it also develop an expertise of the employee to understand the need of the particular client. But the trade-off is that the people have a, employees have a less understanding about the other types of the clients in the organization. So when we are talking about the general manager who has a understanding of the multiple functions and the multiple division, so it's important to give them the exposure of the different kind of a product and the clients, so they have a better understanding when they assume the position of a general manager. Okay, so these are the bureaucratic structure, client-based structure, product-based structure, geographical-based structure, functional structure. Another form is the matrix structure. And matrix structure, that's one example of the matrix structure. And combine two types of the structure into one, typically based on the functional or the functional and the projects or the product division. For example, you look into the, let's say there are the black rectangles and the circles represented the functional structure, where on your left side, and the square represented a product structure. So the project team manufacturing operation is reporting to the two managers, and they're working into the two groups. So these two groups and the they are reporting to the two managers and the two groups. So that matrix structure are very flexible and allow organization to put together team based on their employee skills and employee experiences. So you can have a multiple use of a one employee with a different project and with the different function as well. Matrix structure gives each employee two chains of command and the two managers, and two groups to interact, and two sources of information to consider. And sometimes it can create a high level of stress for the employee as well to meet the demands of the both managers and the both groups. And so that's why they need to have a good political skills if they want to be succeed in the matrix structure, in addition to their competencies and the abilities. Okay. So why do some organizations have a different structure than others? There are some organizational design issues. They're depending upon the technology, their structure, their size, and then their elements of structure, work specialization, chain of command, and other factors which we have discussed. And that resulted into the different kind of the organization forms. So you look into the left side, business environment, company strategy, technology, and size lead to the decision about the different kind of elements of structure. And this organizational structure has a tendency toward the mechanistic and the organization or the organic structure. And then there are different kind of the common organizational form, like simple structure and the bureaucratic structure, which emerges on the basis of the decision which we have taken for the elements of structure. And the type of the environment and the company strategy, technology, and the size in which the companies are operating. How important is structure? Changes to an organization structure can have a negative effect on the employees who work for the company, at least in the short term. The process of changing an organization structure is called restructuring. Restructuring has a weak negative effect on the task performance. People are used to do the work in a certain way. When it changes, so it takes time to adjust into the new work habits. That's why it affects, it has a little negative effect on the performance, whereas the moderate negative effect on the commitment and effective commitment tend to be lower in the organization that restructure. If due to the restructuring, if the new groups emerges and the people are leaving their groups, and if they have a strong association in that groups, so that basically possible reason for the negative effect on the organization. So that's it for today. This meeting we have discussed about the organization structure. Hopefully you have learned it. If you like it, then please do like it. If you want to have some comment, then leave comment over here. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.